Hey friends, welcome to the YouTube channel All About Electronics. So in the earlier video of the clamper circuit, we have already seen what is clamper circuit, and then we have discussed in detail about the positive and the negative clamper circuit. Now in case of the positive clamper circuit, if we apply the sine wave with a peak value of Vm, then this circuit shifts the entire waveform upwards by the Vm volt. And if you see the ideal waveform, then the ideal waveform would look like this. But due to the voltage drop across this diode, it won't behave like a perfect clamper circuit. And if you see the actual waveform, then it will look like this. So this problem can be avoided by using the active clamper circuit. So in this video, we will see the active clamper circuit which is designed using the op-amp. And this circuit is also known as the precision clamper circuit, because in this circuit, the diode behaves like an ideal diode. So there will not be any voltage drop across this diode. So if we apply the sine wave with the peak value of Vm to the circuit, then we will get this type of waveform. That means the entire waveform will get DC shifted by the Vm volt. So this circuit consists of the capacitor, the diode and the amplifier. And here the load resistor RL is connected at the output terminal, and this resistor R1 is connected to prevent the op-amp from the excessive discharge current through this capacitor, particularly when all the DC voltage sources are switched off. So if you see this circuit, here the diode is connected in the feedback loop. So this op-amp will operate in the closed loop configuration whenever the diode is conducting. And whenever it is not conducting, then the op-amp will operate in the open loop configuration. And it will get clear to you during the analysis of this circuit. Now for the clamper circuit, we know that the RC time constant of the circuit should be much larger than the time period of the signal. So here during the analysis, we will assume that the RC time constant of the circuit is much larger than the time period of the signal. So with this assumption, now let us analyze the circuit. So first of all, let us see what happens during the positive half cycle. Now here, initially this capacitor is uncharged. And during the positive half cycle, this input voltage Vin will be greater than 0. So here, let's say the voltage at this inverting terminal is equal to V minus, and the voltage at the non-inverting terminal of the op-amp is equal to V plus. So here, this V plus is grounded, that means V plus is equal to 0 volt, and this voltage V minus is equal to Vin plus Vc, where Vc is the voltage across this capacitor. And here, there won't be any voltage drop across this resistor R1, because we know that in case of the op-amp, there won't be any flow of current into the op-amp terminals. That means there won't be any voltage drop across this resistor R1. And that is why V minus will be equal to Vin plus Vc. And initially, as the capacitor is uncharged, so we can say that this voltage V minus is equal to Vin. So now during the positive half cycle, as the input voltage is greater than 0, so we can say that this voltage V minus will be greater than 0. That means this voltage V minus will be greater than V plus. And due to that, this op-amp will go towards the negative saturation. So the output of this op-amp will be equal to negative saturation voltage. And due to that, this diode will remain off. So if we see the equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. So we can say that during the positive half cycle, this op-amp will operate in the open loop configuration. And the output voltage Vout can be given as Vin plus Vc. So during the positive half cycle, the current will flow in this direction. Now as I said earlier, the RC time constant of this clamper circuit is very large. And due to that, the capacitor will not get charged during this period. So we can assume that during this positive half cycle, the capacitor will remain uncharged. And due to that, we can say that the output voltage Vout will be equal to Vin. So during the positive half cycle, if you see the output voltage, then it will look like this. Now let's see what happens during the negative half cycle. So after this time T by 2, the input voltage is going into the negative direction. So now this voltage V minus, which is equal to Vin plus Vc, will become negative. Or we can say that this voltage V minus is less than V plus. So due to that, now the op amp will go towards the positive saturation voltage, and due to that, now this diode will get turned on. So we can say that after this time T/2, now the op amp will operate in the closed loop configuration, and due to the negative feedback, we can apply the concept of virtual ground. That means if V plus is 0 volt, then the voltage at this negative terminal will be equal to 0, and the same voltage will also appear at this terminal. That means the output voltage V out will be also equal to 0, because we know that no current will flow into the op amp terminals, and due to that, there won't be any voltage drop across this resistor R1. So the same voltage will also appear at this terminal. So if we redraw this portion of the circuit during the negative half cycle, then it will look like this. So during this negative half cycle, now the capacitor will start charging in this direction, and it will charge up to the peak value of voltage Vm. So starting from this time T/2 to the time T3/4, this capacitor will get charged to the peak value of voltage Vm. And during that time, if you see the output voltage, then the output voltage Vout will be equal to 0. So at time T3/4, the voltage across the capacitor will be equal to Vm. And at that time, if you see the voltage V minus, then it can be given as Vin plus Vm. Now after this time T3/4, the input voltage starts increasing from minus Vm towards the 0 volt. That means after this time T3/4, this voltage V minus will become positive. So we can say that after this time T3/4, this voltage V minus will be greater than V plus. And due to that, now the op amp will go into the negative saturation, and once again, this diode will get turned off. So after this time T3/4, now the op amp will operate in the open loop configuration. And in this configuration, the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus Vc. And here, the voltage across the capacitor is equal to Vm. That means the output voltage V out will be equal to input voltage V in plus Vm. So during this time from T3/4 to T, if you see the output voltage, then it will look like this. Now after this, during the second positive half cycle, the voltage V minus will be equal to V in plus Vm. And now, as the input voltage starts increasing in the positive direction, so this voltage V minus will remain greater than 0. So during this second positive half cycle, this voltage V minus is greater than V plus. And due to that, this op amp will operate in the open loop configuration. And in this configuration, the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus Vm. So during this second positive half cycle, if you see the output waveform, then it will look like this. And then after, during the negative half cycle also, the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus Vm, because in this case also, the op amp will operate in the open loop configuration, because this voltage V minus is still greater than V plus. So in that case, the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus Vm. So during this negative half cycle, if you see the output waveform, then it will look like this. So in short, in a steady state condition, if you see the output waveform of this circuit, then it will look like this. So we can say that this circuit is the active positive clamper circuit, because this circuit shifts the entire waveform upwards by the Vm volt. And here is the simulation result of the similar kind of circuit. So here, the input signal is a sinusoidal signal, and it is varying between minus 3 and 3 volt. So if you see the output waveform of the circuit, then it will get DC shifted upwards by the 3 volt. And here, just by reversing the direction of this diode, it is possible to use this circuit as the negative clamper circuit. And not only that, by adding the reference voltage or the biasing voltage to this circuit, it is possible to additionally DC shift this entire waveform upwards by the reference voltage. So this type of circuit is known as the active clamper circuit with the biasing voltage. So let us quickly analyze this circuit. And to easily analyze this circuit, let us take some numbers. So here, let's say the biasing or the reference voltage is equal to 5 volt, and the input voltage is the sinusoidal voltage which is varying from 12 volt to minus 12 volt. So now let's see what happens during the first positive half cycle. So in this circuit, at time t is equal to 0, the input voltage Vin is equal to 0 and initially the capacitor is uncharged. So at time t is equal to 0, this voltage V minus will be equal to Vin plus Vc. And as the input voltage Vin is equal to 0, so we can say that at time t is equal to 0, this voltage V minus is equal to 0 volt. And here voltage V plus is equal to 5 volt. So at time t is equal to 0, this voltage V plus is greater than V minus. So due to that, the op-amp will go towards the positive saturation voltage. And due to that, this diode will become on. So we can say that at time t is equal to 0, the op-amp will operate in the closed loop configuration. And due to this negative feedback, we can apply the concept of virtual ground. So we can say that the voltage at this inverting terminal is also equal to 5 volt. And the same voltage will also appear at the output terminal. So at time t is equal to 0, the voltage at the output will be equal to 5 volt. And the same voltage will also appear at across this capacitor, because initially the input voltage Vin is equal to 0. So at time t is equal to 0, if we redraw this portion of the circuit, then it will look like this. So at time t is equal to 0, the capacitor will charge in this direction and immediately it will get charged to the 5 volt. So we can say that at time t is equal to 0, the voltage across the capacitor is equal to 5 volt. Now after this time t is equal to 0, or at time t is equal to 0 plus, now the input voltage starts increasing in the positive direction. So at time t is equal to 0 plus, we can say that the voltage V minus is equal to Vin plus Vc, that is equal to Vin plus 5 volt. And here the voltage V plus is equal to 5 volt. So we can say that during this positive half cycle, this voltage V minus is greater than V plus. So due to that, now the op-amp will go into the negative saturation, and due to that, this diode will get turned off. So during the positive half cycle, if you see the equivalent circuit, then it will look like this. And at that time, the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus Vc, or in this case, it will be equal to V in plus 5 volt. So in short, we can say that during the positive half cycle, the entire waveform will get DC shifted upwards by the 5 volt. And if you see the output waveform, then it will look like this. So now let's see what happens during the negative half cycle. Now during the positive half cycle, as I said, the RC time constant of the circuit is very large. So we can assume that the voltage across the capacitor is still almost equal to 5 volt. That means whenever this negative half cycle starts, then the voltage across the capacitor Vc will still remain 5 volt. And now during this negative half cycle, starting from this T by 2 to T 3 by 4 time, the input voltage will reduce. That means it will reduce from 0 volt towards the minus Vm volt. That means during this time, this voltage V minus will be equal to Vin plus 5 volt. And as the input voltage is reducing, so this voltage V minus will become less than V plus. So basically, for this time T by 2 to 3T by 4, as the voltage V plus is greater than V minus, the op-amp will momentarily go into the positive saturation. And that will turn on this diode, and due to that, now this circuit will operate in the closed loop configuration. And due to that, now the voltage which is appearing at the output terminal will be equal to 5 volt. That means during this time from T by 2 to 3T by 4, the output voltage V out will be equal to 5 volt. And the same 5 volt will also appear at this terminal. So if we redraw this portion of the circuit, then it can be redrawn like this. So during this time from T by 2 to 3T by 4, the capacitor will start charging in this direction. And at time 3T by 4, the voltage across the capacitor will be equal to Vm plus 5 volt. And in this case, I can say that it will be equal to 12 plus 5 volt, that is equal to 17 volt. that means at time 3T/4, the voltage across the capacitor will be equal to 17 volt. Now at this time, this voltage V minus can be given as V in plus 17 volt. That means this voltage will appear at this terminal. Now after this point, the input voltage starts increasing from minus Vm to 0. Or in this case, it is start increasing from minus 12 towards the 0 volt. So after this time, this voltage V minus will be greater than 5 volt. So for this time T3/4 to T, this voltage V minus will be greater than V plus. And due to that, the op-amp will go towards the negative saturation. Or we can say that due to that, this diode will remain off. So for this time, starting from 3T/4 to T, this op-amp will operate in the open loop configuration. And in this configuration, the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus 17 volt. So if you see the output waveform during this time, then it will look like this. That means the output voltage V out will go from 5 volt towards the 17 volt. Now let's see what happens during the next positive half cycle. So during the next positive half cycle, still this V minus can be given as V in plus 17 volt. And now as the input voltage is increasing in the positive direction, so this voltage V minus will be greater than V plus. So once again, this op-amp will operate in the open loop configuration. And due to that, the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus 17 volt. So if you see the output waveform during this second positive half cycle, then it will look like this. And then after, during the next negative half cycle, still the output voltage V out can be given as V in plus 17 volt. So if you see the output waveform, then it will look like this. So in a steady state condition, if you see the output waveform, then it can be represented like this. So in this way, using this biasing voltage, it is possible to shift the output waveform to the desired level. And here is the simulation result of the similar type of circuit. So here the reference voltage is 1 volt and the input voltage is a 3 volt sinusoidal signal. So here the blue waveform is the input waveform and this green waveform is the output waveform. So as you can see, using this active clamper circuit, it is possible to eliminate the voltage drop across this diode. So I hope in this video you understood how we can design this active clamper circuit using this op-amp. And we will see some examples based on this type of circuit in the quiz section. So if you have any question or suggestion, do let me know here in the comment section below. If you like this video, hit the like button and subscribe the channel for more such videos.